Now, in this video, I want to talk about the law of polarization. And it's a universal law. It's one of seven laws that are written in a book called The Cow and the Lion by the Three Initiates. It's written in 2012 during the mind shift. But the only law that it doesn't state in this book, which is more important, probably just as equal, it's called the Law of Agreements. But superseding law is called the Law of Mentality. And that's basically, as a man thinks, so does he attract in his world. Which is the basis behind the books, Think and Grow Rich. Which is right from the Proverbs. As a man thinks in his heart, so he is. It's all the same thing. But I want to talk about the Law of Polarity. And the way the Law of Polarity works is, if you can just imagine like a Polaris missile. It's the missile that the end-all missile. Everybody's going to launch their Polaris missiles from the animal brain, so to speak, when people don't get along. But you can actually, when you realize your animal brain and your upper brain, the cerebrum, lower brain, the cerebellum, when your cerebellum launches an attack on your cerebrum, your cerebrum's Polaris missile is the end all of havoc to restore peace. It doesn't cut the giant's head off, it rehabilitates the giant. So it's basically the difference between the kingdom of King David in the Old Testament and the kingdom of his son Solomon, which was the kingdom of peace, which is based around commercial trade with all the nations, learn how to get along with each other, which was established through prison planet city systems to bring us out from the jungle of the killer kill be world of the caveman, through evolution of millions of years that we've been evoluting from a tiny little microscopic water vessel. So, and then of course you had the paper record known as the Bible. Before the man Adam was put on the public record, there were men before him. He just happened to be the first man written on paper. They used to have rock records, and you can get into the Sumerian records that are long past 6,000 years ago. Planets much, much older than just 6,000 years, and it's been proven through science. But, and like I say, we had the mind shift, and people are starting to realize this, and they're bringing a balance between the Eastern knowledge and the Western knowledge. But it's tied into the law of mentality, which is, as a man thinks, so think and grow rich. And rich in two ways, both spiritually and physically. Now, getting into the law of polarity, when basically what's going on is you got a negative and a positive end of the spectrum of everything. It's known as your happy face, your sad face. When you walk through town, you see the people wearing their t-shirts, got the happy face, the sad face. That's just telling you that there's a negative and there's a positive to life. But we want to do is find the balance in the middle. And we don't want to continually going from sad to happy to sad to happy all the time throughout our days, weeks, years, and life. We want to find that middle ground of total happiness. And we do that by what's called the law of polarity, where we launch a Polaris missile. When we start feeling either overexcited, we automatically tell our brain, or say in our mind, or have this thought. You want to neutralize it, and you say, I'm not going to be over happy. Or if you're feeling sad, angry, down, depressed, fearful, all those things are rooted in fear, you say automatically, you have to launch your Polaris missile, and you have to tell yourself, and you have to think it. Boom, just like that. You got to be fast to the trigger and say, no, I'm not going to be fearful. No, I'm not going to be worried. No, I'm not going to be anxious. Now, once you do that, in order to find your neutral ground, you have to ask yourself one question. What am I doing to attract these thoughts into my life? I keep having fear thoughts. I keep having thoughts that I might get sick, thoughts that I might go off the deep end. You know, all these things that bring you into the negativity. So, now the answer to that question, what am I doing to attract this into my life? Number one is you don't have a claim of lien in the public record on your body that says that no one on this earth or nothing on this earth can collect from you. And you have to remind yourself that. And it's hard to do because you'll forget yourself and you'll forget what to say. But through practice, time and time again, once you find yourself being over happy, you automatically tell yourself, wait, I'm a calm person. I ain't gotta be over happy. Calm down, calm down, calm down. Then ask yourself the question. Once you've pulled yourself out of the muck and the mire, the quicksand, you've got to do that quickly. And that's called launching your Polaris missile, man. You got to be quick on the trigger. You got to fire that thing right away. Because you can go into deep, deep depression within seconds. You'll get a letter in the mail from an attorney that says, you're summoned to court for such and such. Someone's suing you. And your heart will drop just like that. And you might even have a heart attack right there on the spot. You've got to be able to launch your Polaris missile and say, there's nothing to fear. And then quickly pull yourself out of the mire, or you're going to go in deep, quick, and die. You're going to have a heart attack. And you just might be paralyzed from it. You don't want that to happen. So once you pull yourself out quickly, you got to do this. Time and time again, you got to learn how to do this every time it happens. Then you got to ask yourself one question. What am I doing? What am I doing that's attracting this into my life? What am I doing that's attracting these fears, these thoughts, these anxieties, these worries? Or on the other end of the spectrum, what am I doing to be overly happy, overly hyper, enthusiastic, too over the top? Right? Remember, you got two ends of the spectrum. Sad face, the happy face. We want the middle ground. So once you launch your Polaris missile and you tell yourself, no, I ain't gonna fear. There's nothing to fear. Or you tell yourself, no, I'm not gonna be overexcited. Once you do that, ask yourself this one question quickly. What am I doing to attract these thoughts into my mind all the time? And you're gonna have to answer your question this one way. This is your answer. Your answer is you do not have a security agreement or a claim of lien. Those two documents, affidavits recorded in the public record that says that nothing and no man can collect from you. That includes bills, utilities, bank bills, taxes, property tax, everything. That includes sicknesses, worry, disease, anger, fear, depression. None of that can collect from you. If you do not have the legal paperwork in the system recorded in the public, an actual claim of lien that no one can collect from you and nothing can collect from you, that includes death. This is your ticket to eternal life also. So, once again, let's go over it again. It's called the law of polarity. This is the universal law. If you're swinging back and forth between positive and negative all the time, one day you're down and out, another day you're overly happy, another day you're sad, another day you're overly enthusiastic. You might do good for a week and find a little bit of balance, and then one week, all of a sudden, you're depressed. Just like that, boom. Someone says something to you, ridicules you, all of a sudden you're depressed, quick, boom. Anytime you feel yourself feeling out of balance, immediately you've got to fire your Polaris missile, and you got to take yourself to the opposite end of the rhythm and say, no, there's nothing to fear. No, I'm not going to have a heart attack. No, I'm not going to get sick. No. You've got to tell yourself that. If you don't, you're in danger. And you might just slowly start sinking. You might think within your power you can bring yourself out of it. You're fooling yourself. because it's going to happen again and again and again until finally when it starts happening again and again, you have no resistance. You automatically sink. You'll actually collapse. Fear will cause you to collapse. Worry, anxiety will cause you to collapse eventually, instantly. You see it happen in life all the time. Now, like I said, once you instantly shoot your Polaris missile, you gotta pull yourself out instantly. You gotta be quick to the trigger, man. And you gotta realize what's going on fast. Then you gotta ask yourself this one question. Remember this one question. What am I doing that's attracting these thoughts in my life? Because it's the law of the universe, is the law of attraction. As a man thinks in his heart, so does the universe give right back to you. What you sow is what you reap. So you've got to ask yourself the question, what am I doing to attract this? And then you got to answer your question quickly. And you have to remember these things. I don't have a claim, a lien on my body so that nothing can collect from me. That includes man. Includes all sicknesses, poverty. All everything that has to do with on the negative spectrum is going to take you down. That includes death. You've got to put a security agreement and a claim a lien in the public record on your body. You got to study and understand what you just did. Think about that. You've got to make the public record. You've got to put your truth of who you are on this earth on the public record. Because if you don't, the legal system that's been put in place here as a good training system to train you how to be nice and get along with people, the legal system, you're bound to it. And the legal system is all based on assumption, right from your birth. Mama signs you over on a birth certificate. Bam, you're now a corporate citizen. And if you don't understand what just happened, they have the right to collect everything from you. That includes viruses can collect from you. That includes your health. Your money, they'll send you bills, one bill after another, taxes, jurisdiction, they'll say you got to go here, you got to go there, here's the prison, you need to go to prison. Now, if you did something actually deserving punishment, don't question it. You need to go to prison. You need to be rehabbed, especially. I'm talking about for things that are kind of unnecessary, going to jail unnecessarily because the pirates have created extra rules on top of rules that are actually unnecessary. But most of the rules are good. There are some unnecessary ones, though. So if you go through the stop sign, smash into someone and cause them a bunch of harm where they got to spend some time in the hospital and the cop does a DUI test on you and you're drunk, well, you need to hit some special rehab, quick. Because we don't just let people out on the road like that. That's unsafe. That's not peaceful. We want to be smart. We want to rehab these people. Now, you want to rehab them with truth, though. You don't just want to rehab them to rehab them. You want to tell them what the real truth is, how the system works on the earth. That's real rehab. Because the reason they're getting drunk is because they're flooded with all kinds of emotions they can't deal with that they don't know how to polarize because they don't understand the laws of the universe. Point blank. They don't know how to deal with their relationship, so they wash it away with alcohol. Nothing wrong with alcohol. I'm just saying to the point where you got to get behind a car and now you've caused injury to everybody and you're swerving all over the road. Now you're a havoc. You're a hazard. That's a public hazard. We can't have that. That's common sense. If you want to get drunk in your own house and do your own thing, but if you want to turn up the stereo at 2 o'clock in the morning at full blast, that's cause to unpeaceful. That's cause for unpeacefulness. And so someone's probably gonna call, and you're gonna have a cop knock on the door and say, "Turn it down." And if you get the cop a bad time, he's gonna cuff you, take you in. Teach you a lesson because you're being unpeaceful. So, but if you can learn how to polarize these emotions that, you know, cause some of these things that we do, if you learn how to apply the laws of the universe, And like I say, you can get a copy of these laws of the universe from this book called Kabbalion. It's only about 100 pages. It's written by the three initiates. It was written in 2012, known as the Mayan Shift. This is information, the laws of the universe that the Freemasons and the Illuminati know. These are the secrets of the ancients. All this ancient knowledge is being made public now. It's on YouTube. There ain't no secrets no more. Sure, there's been some bad guys in the Freemasonry and the Illuminati. These are called pirates. These are the people that have been stepping on everybody. But they're being exposed. They're being rehabbed as we speak. And there's still a bunch of them loose. But they're going to come around. That's what this mind shift is all about. But at the root of it, it's called putting in your security agreement and your claim of lien on your body, on your property, on your share of the birth certificate application bond, which is connected to all the resources of the earth so you can live this life without having to work a job. Yes, and jobs are going to be obsolete here. We're going to phase out of the job system. Everybody's going to learn how to live off the land. And we will manufacture stuff too. But eventually, it's all going to be privatized. It's not going to be all corporate. And eventually, we're going to get out of all rules and regulations. We're just going to learn how to be nice with one another and share with what we have. It's all going to just be a share or share be world. And we're phasing into that. Like I say, we had to come out of the jungle, the killer kill be world, into prison planet cities to teach us rules and regulations, how to be peaceful with each other. Quit beating each other up. And then to learn how to sign ourselves out of that prison with an authentic security agreement and a claim of lien so that the pirates cannot collect from you anymore. That includes taxes, bills, utilities, anything, money exchanged over the counter for retail products. That's all fading out. But like I said, this video is all about launching your Polaris missile. It's called the Law of Polarity. When you're starting to get worry in your life, or if you're going over to the other side being over happy, you gotta automatically tell yourself, there's nothing to fear. You gotta pull yourself out of that quicksand quick. And remember this one question you gotta ask yourself: what am I doing to attract this in my thoughts? And then you're gonna answer that question real quick too. Because remember, you're not gonna forget a lot of times. You're gonna forget. And you're going to be sinking in the mire of worry. And then all of a sudden, while you're down there, you just might remember, oh yeah, damn, I got to ask myself the question. Or, you know, you got to pull yourself out first, launch your missile. There's nothing to fear, nothing to fear. Grab a hold of yourself and shake yourself if you have to. There's nothing to worry about. And you be serious about it. You got to pull yourself out. Wait a second, there's nothing to worry about. Okay? And then you got to ask yourself this question. What am I doing to attract these thoughts in my mind? And then I'm going to give you the answer. Answer yourself. It's because you don't have an authentic security agreement on your body. And a claim of lien on your body. And all of your share of the resources on this earth. That includes property, house, car, and retail merchandise. Because at the root of all your fears and anxiety, it's, I don't have enough, I don't have enough, I don't have enough, I'm not free, I can't be myself. That's at the root of everything. Because you're under the assumptive jurisdiction of what's called Prison Planet. And it was made to be that way. And you'll learn this when you study. We had to come out of the jungle, killing each other, Prison Planet, teach us rules, how to be safe, to the third shift called the Mayan Shift we're phasing into, which is everybody's going to learn how to write their own claim of lien, put it in the public record, so that they can access their birth certificate account, which is tied to a computer button that says, everything's free on Earth. And you don't have to work jobs no more. And everybody's going to phase out little by little. And there's always going to be someone there working a job till they learn. So there'll be plenty of stuff on the shelf for you to get until we make the big shift. Like I said, everybody's going to start growing their own food, being self-responsible, making their own stuff, trading with other people. Hey, I got a skill, I'll trade with you. These are all the laws of agreement that this universe really operates on. But in order to get there, we had to go through the jungle, stage, caveman, prison planet, which is just a stage of rules to teach us how to be nice so we don't kill each other and punch each other out like we were doing in the jungle, to creating our own world, which is what you see on TV. Everywhere you look on the commercials, it's all about create your own reality. Well, you can only do that when you put a claim lien on your body, on your share of the resources of the earth. And if you want to learn how to do that, you go to Solutions and Commerce on YouTube and listen to the teacher, Winston Trout, teach you. Otherwise, I can teach you. And yes, I've already done all this stuff. And yes, I have my share of the pie. I just had my first private trust check negotiation through the retail store. And nothing came out of my public account. They just press the button, free. And what they do is they automatically give cash to the retail store because that's what they want. That's what they're used to operating out of. So, but this video is all about polarity, the law of polarity. So remember, if you find yourself sinking in fear, you say, no, there's nothing to fear. Ask yourself the question, what am I doing to cause myself to think like this? And then answer your question quickly. It's because you don't have a claimant lien on your body. You have to sign yourself out of prison planet. The only way you can get out from under the assumption of jurisdiction is you got to make the record that, and give it to the corporation, and they will agree to it automatically. After 3 days, they'll acquiesce. They say, oh, we got someone here who knows the name of the game. Oh. That's just one diaper they have, one diaper less they got to wipe, and they're happy for you. But they'll test you. You'll go through all the tests. They'll knock on your door, sheriffs on the door, cops on the door, process servers. Hey, you need to pay this, court judgments, when you ain't got to. It's all just a bluff. They want to see if you're going to run away or if you're going to pay them. So you got to face the giant. Not to cut his head off, but to rehab the giant. You've got to show the giant that you're a man of peace and you know the name of the game, the laws of the universe. When you can do these things, Mother Nature's going to grant you, not grant, but give you access. Because a grant is something that can be taken away. A grant is something that someone gives you and they can take it away. This ain't a grant. You have now the authority. Access that birth certificate application bond credit that your labor backs. All paper money was taken off the gold standard a long time ago and replaced with people as collateral for the bank loan of the Revolutionary War to the Bank of England. In 1933, they passed House Joint Resolution 192. Said because of the federal emergency. What was the federal emergency? They didn't have enough gold to pay the debt. So they confiscated what gold they had left from all the people, put it aside, and they went into another third stage of bankruptcy. And the Bank of England said, who do you got as collateral? Or what do you got as collateral this time? Because the first bankruptcy, they gave them all their buildings. The second bankruptcy, they gave them all their land. Third bankruptcy, they gave them all the people. So you are the backing of the birth certificate application bond. And it was made to be that way. This system was set up that way on purpose. And it operates in fraud on purpose that way through its assumptive jurisdiction, all on purpose to get you to realize to be peaceful. And that you got to put the record on the public record, a real agreement, a law of agreements. That's the universal law. If you're under assumption of agreement, then you're stuck under legal codes. And so you're stuck under what's called fear. Anger, worry, anxiety, and you can launch your Polaris missile, pull yourself out of it, say there's nothing to fear. Why am I having these fear thoughts? Automatically ask yourself the question. It's because you don't have a claim to lean in on your body, and everyone and everything wants to collect from you. That includes bills, your health, and even your body as death. Once you understand the laws of the universe, now you can create your own reality. and the world's unlimited. You can do anything you want, anything you can think. This brain is the most powerful thing in the universe. Think about these things. All right, talk to you later.